I want to invite you to something amazing. I want to call you towards something really powerful. We all have challenges. I do as well. We have problems. I do as well. What are these problems? You have health matters. Every year, twice, thrice, more or less, you have a health matter. You'll have a flu, seasonal. They call it a seasonal flu. Nobody on earth has perfect health. Nobody can say, I've never ever had a single problem with my health. Every human being has had issues. Small or big, that's a different thing. But you've had them. Sneeze, what else? Then you start feeling a bit of a headache. What else? Sinuses, then what else? Sometimes it goes worse, sometimes it gets better from that point. Sometimes as you feel you're picking something, you know what needs to be done, so you do it, so you feel a bit better. But what happened? It came. Didn't it come in your direction? So every year you'll have a health matter. Sometimes you'll have financial issues. As wealthy as you may be, you could slide quicker than those who probably don't have much. It can be. It's okay. It has happened. What else? You may be struggling in your faith because the challenges of the globe, it's possible. You're not the first one. Don't think you're rejected by Allah. You're not. You're just going through struggles. People struggle with their faith. They come out a few years later, a few days later, some time later, stronger than they ever were before. But Allah creates situations in your lives and mine to help us come out of these things. Sometimes negativity happens. What happened as a result? We became better Muslims. We became people who were acquainted with Allah in a better way. As a result of what? As a result of something that would have otherwise led us to suicidal thoughts. May Allah protect all of us. So if you're struggling with something, please go easy on yourself, but remedy it. Remedy it. Go easy on yourself. The reason I say this, many people tend to lose faith simply because they think they've hit rock bottom and now there's nothing to be done. That's the end. It's not the end. Allah decides when the end is. For you, let me tell you what I wanted to say. The most powerful piece of advice for this evening, starting with myself. What do you think it is? We're believers, right? Let me tell you, your five daily prayers, hold on to them, work on them. Your five daily prayers, work on them, become strong on them, and see the miracles that start happening in your life. The message this evening is, work on your prayer. You won't go wrong. You know what? It's ultimate success. Tell yourself every time you're being lazy, Allah is greater. And whatever I'm busy with right now, stop it and go and pray. Even if you start with farad, that's what's compulsory initially, and then you can work on a little bit more later. But don't give up. Build. If you're doing 3 out of 5, go on to 4, go on to 5, inshallah. If you're weak, start somewhere, but pray. I promise you, it will change your life. Your problems will be diminished. I'm not saying they will be solved, but they'll become small. You actually tell yourself, I can't believe I used to consider this a problem. It's not even a problem. Learn to take things in your stride. As things happen in your life, we look at it with the eye of the Quran. What that means is, you look at it the way you are taught by the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he lost his children one after the other, guess what? He was sad. He even cried tears. It's normal. I'm a human. I'll cry. Crying is not a bad thing. It's the way humans were created to process certain emotional conditions. It's normal to cry sometimes. It's okay. But you will not utter that which is displeasing to Allah. And you will ask Allah to make it easy for me. Oh Allah, you tested me with a massive one. Make it easy for me. Oh Allah, make it easy for me. Help me. Give me the sabr. Oh Allah, give me the sabr. Call out to Allah. Make dua to Him. Supplicate. Ask Him. He will give you. He will give you. When you say, Astaghfirullah. Oh Allah, I seek your forgiveness. Are we not taught to repeat it many times? So many times a day. The Prophet ﷺ used to seek forgiveness many times a day, 70 times. Sometimes it is said up to 100 times a day. Can I say something to you? Do you know the reason why we repeat seeking forgiveness? Is it because we are doubting the mercy of Allah? Is it because we are doubting the mercy of Allah? No, definitely not. It is because we want the status that we have and the connection with Allah to be stronger and the status to be elevated. That's what it is. When you say, oh Allah, forgive me. Imagine for a moment I did something wrong to you, right? I did something wrong to you. And I'm so embarrassed about it that whenever I see you, I just remember that thing and I say, hey, listen, I'm sorry. You say, nah, it's okay. Done, forgiven. When I see you again, I say, hey, brother, I still think that what I did to you was so... I said, don't worry, it's okay, man, it's over. Right? Why did I repeat it? Because I thought of it and I said, no, man forgave me, but you know what? Let me say it again. And then when I see you after 2 years, hey, what's up, my man? Hey, I still feel it in my heart. You know what I did to you was like this. To be honest with you, it's got nothing to do with me doubting the forgiveness. It's got to do with the fact I'm embarrassed, number one. Number two is, it will solidify the connection. And when you have a connection with Allah, you have nothing to worry.
Look at the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wherein he departed for Salatul Fajr, leaving his wife on the place of reading Salah. And when he returned, she was still sitting in the same place. And he returned after the sun had risen. And he asks her, what have you been doing all along? And she said, well, I was praising Allah and I was declaring the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah. How great is that? I'm sure all of us would love to be able to do that on a regular basis. But now listen to what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says. He says, can I teach you four words? Subhanallah. Can I teach you only four words? That if you were to utter them thrice, they are better for you than everything you have done from the time I left to the time I returned. Subhanallah, four little words. What are these words? This is why we say, do not underestimate the value of the words that come out of your mouth. Be careful, in the same way that good words have a massive goodness of impact, the bad words would also affect you negatively in a huge, huge way. Let's listen to these four beautiful words. Before I say them, I repeat, he said, I will teach you four words. If you are to repeat them thrice, they are better for you than everything that you have uttered from the time I left to the time I returned. And listen to these words. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. This is obviously declaring the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he continues to say, adada khalqihi. What amount of praise am I praising Allah? The amount of His creation, I don't even know. The amount of His creation, how much ever and whatever He has created, to that amount I am praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ridha nafsihi. And until He is pleased, whatever makes Him happy, subhanallah, I am praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala up to the point of His pleasure. When He is pleased with me, the point of His pleasure. Adada khalqihi wa ridha nafsihi wa zinata arshihi. The weight of His throne, subhanallah. Zinata arshihi refers to the weight of the throne. What is the weight of the throne? It is something well beyond our comprehension. We won't understand it. These are words of praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa midada kalimatihi. Subhanallah. You know, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His words are grand, they are great, they are stretched beyond the east to the west. What we see as east to west is actually nothing. It is minor in comparison to what Allah has created. So asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the praise that I am declaring of you, the glorification that I am declaring of you, oh the greatest one, should be stretched out well beyond your words. Allahu Akbar. What are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They are beyond our comprehension. We don't even know. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us it.
When calamity strikes in your life, and it has to strike at some point, the first thing a believer should do is connect to Allah. Alladhina idha asabathum musibah qalu inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Allah describes the believers, and Allah says, those whom when calamity strikes, when difficulty and hardship befalls them, the first thing they say and they utter is, we belong to Allah and unto Him we shall all return. So when calamity strikes, the first thing you do is you say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. I belong to Allah. What does that mean? As a believer, the fact that you know you belong to your Maker, He made you, He has you here for a short time, and you are going to go back to Him, that will cushion whatever difficulty you are going through. Don't think that you won't have hardship in your life. Do not think that calamity shall not strike you. It has to strike you. If not today, then tomorrow. If it has not already struck, it is coming. And if it struck once, it may strike many times. And a lot of us have had it many times already. Guess what? It does not get any easier. It gets bigger, because that is the plan of Allah. He rewards you in a greater way as time passes. You think it was simple because you lost a child. Wait until you lose three or four one time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not test us with that. So when calamity strikes, we say we belong to Allah. We believe that we belong to Allah, because a believer is such that you don't just utter words, you believe them. I don't just say inna lillah and I don't even know what I'm saying. You hear about the death of a person, isn't that calamity striking from one angle? Yes, it is. What do you say? Inna lillahi wa inna ilahi raji'un. You know what shaitan does? Shaitan makes us say that word as a spontaneous effect of having heard the news, without thinking of the meaning of those words and what we're actually saying. That's what happens. So that's why we're saying, my brothers, my sisters, think of it. Who do you belong to? You belong to Allah. Do you really think as a believer He would do something nasty to you? The answer is no. I lose my limbs, it's not nasty for me. If I have connection with Allah, that's Allah. Destiny is written. Rufi'atil aqlamu wa jaffatis suhufu. The pens have been lifted and the pages are dry. Your destiny is already there. You're going to go through tests that Allah chose for you. So take it in your stride. Inna lillah. Inna lillah. We belong to Allah. I belong to Allah. You belong to Allah. We all belong to Allah. I don't even belong to myself. That's why when you say, this is mine, this is mine, this is mine, hang on, hang on. In actual fact, you and whatever you think is yours is actually Allah's. When you came on earth, you came with zero. You see the professional swimmers, watch them. They glide across. Have you noticed that? Effortlessly, and they're super quick. Mashallah, before you know it, the best of swimmers and the fastest of them are not the ones who kick the water and who want to make the biggest of splashes. They are the ones who glide through silently. You can't really hear much. You don't see a lot of splash, but they're gone before you know. You know what? With us in our iman, when calamity strikes, are you going to be a professional? In the sense that, are you going to be a good Muslim, mu'min? Are you already close to Allah? Does it make you fulfill more salah? Does it bring you closer to Allah? Do you check yourself? And if you do, you know what? You're going to glide through. You're going to actually swim through. Before you know it, you're on the other side of the calamity. Subhanallah, thanking Allah, oh Allah, I thank you for what you bestowed me.